Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install BCP utility and then how to use it in latest SQL Server for fast data import and export. So let's quickly dive into our video. So first you need to double click on SQL Server Management Studio to invoke it. And on our previous videos I have showed you how to use SQL Authentication. So you are going to select with SQL Server Authentication and we are going to provide the username and password, and I'm going to also select this trust server certificate and click on connect, and there you go. So you are connected to our SQL Express. So if you expand the database, currently you can see we have only a couple of databases called employee and player. So that is what we have showed you on our previous videos. So let's quickly invoke a new query window and create some dummy data to a table and then use BCP utility to import those data to a file. So I have already prepared sample queries just to save some time. So I'm going to copy it and paste it over here. So I'll start by creating a database called my database. So it is created. Next I'm going to use my database and then I'm going to create a table called customers with all these different columns. So I'm going to select execute. It is properly executed. And then I'm going to insert all this data. So about 20 records I have. So I'm going to select all this. So, and then I'm going to execute. So 20 row affected. So now if you just simply do select start from customer, you're going to get all these data, right? And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use BCP utility to fetch all this data from a table customers and I'm going to put it to a text file, right? So for that, first you need to have BCP installed on your system. So you can just simply go to search and type CMD to open your command prompt and just simply type BCP space slash question and hit enter. If you are getting this type of prompt, then all that basically means is you have BCP installed on your system. And if you want to know your BCP version, you can just simply type BCP-V and just simply hit enter. You are going to get the BCP version as well. So if you are getting this type of prompt, then all that basically means is you already have BCP installed. So you don't need to reinstall it. But if you are still struggling to get all this, then you can always go to your browser, open a new tab and just simply type BCP utility download, hit enter. So that will show you this bulk copy with BCP utility, and so this link also I'm going to provide on our channel description. So here when you scroll down, you will get all these links. So depending upon what operating system you're using, you need to download that. So on clicking this, you'll be able to see a file downloaded, so you can install this as well to get BCP installed on your system. I have already BCP installed, so that is what I am getting all this prompt. So now it's time to export all this data to a text file. So for that, let's go to our C drive. So this is where we are going to get the file. So I'm going to create a new folder. I'm going to name this folder as export, and I'm going to create a file called customers, hit enter. So I have named it as per my table name, which is customers only. And now what I'm going to do is on our command prompt, I'm going to run a simple command called BCP, then the database name that we have created. So if you remember, we have created a database called my database. So that is what I'm going to type, my database. Then dot dbo, then dot our table name, which is customers in our case, right? So that is what we have created, customers table. Next I'm going to use a command called out, so that is because we are exporting, and then we are going to provide this file. So this export file, so just copy this and paste it over here. So remember, we are using quotation, sorry, what just happened? Oh, I just by mistake hit enter. Yeah, so you need to give double slash and then you need to provide that file name, so that is customers.txt, just end that double quote, and now give a flag called -e, So that is because we want to export it in a character format, and then we are going to give dash t. So that basically signifies it will be a comma separated field. So dash t comma and then dash s. So dash s basically means now we need to provide our SQL server name. So remember, while logging in, if you remember, so we have given a server name over here. So first it will be our system name, that is GS. In our case, you should be getting your own system name, and then you need to provide this SQL Express. So that is what I have used as a server. So I'm going to provide that exact same thing. So GS slash SQL Express. All right, and then dash U. So that is our user. Again, we have, you know, use the username as SA and our password. So that is what I'm going to write it over here. So dash U basically signifies user, and then give your username, which is SA in my case, and then dash P, so that signifies password. So I'm going to give my password. So now you know my password as well. It's a very simple one. So that is it. So this is your command. All right, so now just write this much and just simply hit enter, and there you go, starting copy and 20 row copied. So now if you just simply go to your file, this export directory, you can see file size increased now to 2 KB, and when you open it, you'll get all this data exported over here. So whatever you have inserted on this table, so all this data is now properly exported, right? And it's a comma separated file. So first ID, then first name, last name, email ID, phone number, CT and date, right? So in this way you can easily use BCP utility for exporting data. I have already prepared a very detailed article. So if you come over to this article, again I'm going to post that link in our channel description, and you are going to get all these different article on our official website as well. So you can open it from here also. So here, very detailed, I have explained all the things that I'm already showed on this video. So I had a very detailed explanation about this BCP command syntax, along with explaining all the flags. And this is what we have just now showed, exporting a table to a file. Similarly, you can import it, you can export with a custom query as well, and different, you know, authentication mode along with SQL auth or Windows auth. Only difference is you need to give this dash t flag. So this is exact place where we have given dash s. Instead of that, you can use dash t for using a Windows auth. So all these different things you can always read, and you can learn about best practice, along with, if you are also willing to learn more, you can always refer to this article. So this is official article about BCP utility by Microsoft. So you can read all this to learn more stuffs about BCP utility as well. All right, so yeah, so that's pretty much all about this video. I hope you are really enjoying this video. If you are really enjoying this video, please mention that on our comment sessions. I really love reading all of your comments. So let's set a target of about 100 comments under this video. I really love reading all of your comments, and if you are facing an issue, so that also you can mention. All right, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And if you are interested on Python projects, so then I highly recommend to watch this tutorial. Again, this link I'm going to provide right in our channel description. I'm sure you're going to love all these videos that I'm making on this Python project playlist, and detailed source code of whatever projects that I'm making, along with you'll also get a detailed article as well. So by explaining each and everything, you are going to also get on our article, along with the full source code. So yeah, so that's pretty much all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.